Hello and welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. We are looking at the Stealth 2715 G series, which is the fiberglass and the kicker audio system and some nicer things like that. My name is Mate and we're going to walk through some of the different features here. Outside, as you can see, we are on a toy hauler travel trailer. So this is the ramp door with the cables put up so that you can hang out here with your campsite chair or whatever. You can also get the optional rails if you wanted the rail system here. A couple things I wanted to point out though about this deck is one, that the corners are radiused, which is kind of nice so that you don't have to worry about popping a tire or something like that. And then also you'll notice that this piece of rubber here is just one piece, so it's not seamed together with two pieces that can create a leak or something like that down the road. Another thing that these guys do is when this guy is pushed up, you'll notice there's a nice little lip up here. So when the door is in here and the rain comes down, it doesn't have a potential to leak into your door like some of the other ones do. This has the two back lights and for floodlights, as well as these are all LED running lights. A couple of cool things on the outside here. One, this has got a power awning. So you just push a button for the awning to go in and out. This also has the outside marine grade speakers, as well as a porch light right here too. Aluminum rims. As you can see, this also has the Arctic package option built into it. A few things that includes are one, the aluminum foil insulation, two, an enclosed underbelly, three, a 12 volt heat pads on the tanks themselves. So yeah, some ready for some colder weather if you decide to use it for that. Also the aluminum foil is kind of nice too, because if in the summertime, it'll keep you cooler in the summertime, warmer in the wintertime. Another really big thing that this guy has is a 200 watt solar panel built onto the roof of the coach. It has a one piece rubber roof, and then pre-built is the solar panel. 200 watts is one of the biggest solar panels in the industry, and it has a controller built inside too so that you can see a little display and it'll say how much sun you're getting, how full your batteries are, all that kind of stuff. Another sticker that I wanted to point out to you is the Forest River coach net that you get for the first year. It's 24/7 roadside assistance. It's included on all Forest River coaches. They even have the 1-800 number, so if you do get stuck and you need help, you call that number and then they can help you out. Another cool feature about this guy is it has some pass-through storage right here. Let me show you what this looks like. They put this linoleum down, well, and then it has the optional generator, so it's not fully pass through. But this guy has linoleum down before they even start putting the walls on or the cabinetry and stuff. So it's a one piece of linoleum that goes throughout the coach. This is 40 mil aluminum, so it can handle a lot of stuff being flung at it as you're going down the highway, as well as it has a rock guard up underneath there to protect you from chips and stuff like that. Has a nice little LED light right here on the side so that you can see what you're doing. We upgraded the propane bottles to 30 pound propane bottles on here, which is kind of nice. You can go a little bit longer on your trips without having to worry about having to fill them up. There's just a little switch that you can easily access here from the top. It has an auto changeover regulator, so it'll switch from one propane tank over to the other automatically. This is just a spot for your sewer hose here, and then this is your 4,000 watt Cummins Onan EVAP generator. The cool thing about the EVAP generator is it will drain out your carburetor before when it's not in use, so it doesn't gum it up like you would on a normal Cummins Onan generator. As we go over here, this has an outside shower, black tank flush, so it flushes out your black tank for you, so you don't have to worry about doing that from the inside of the coach. It makes it a lot more convenient. This hot water heater is a gas electric hot water heater. I'll show you, this is an anode rod in case you don't know about these. This is a sacrificial rod that goes right into this hole right here. You pull it out when you want to drain your hot water heater so that you don't have rotten egg smell in your hot water heater from just stagnant water from a long time. And over time, this will get eaten up. Once this gets eaten up about 50%, usually right around the edge right here, you want to replace it. And so that way it doesn't eat away at your tank. Right here is a little electric button that has a piece of tape over it, usually, and that makes it so that you can turn on the electric side or the gas side of the hot water heater. And if you do both at the same time, you'll get up to 16.2 gallons of hot water per hour. It has two little resets right here, one for the electric side and gas side, as well as a pressure release. So if it builds too much pressure from the heat of the water inside the tank, it'll release right there. This has the DSI function, so it has like a built-in spark plug basically right here, so you don't have to come out here, push down the pilot light and light the pilot. You just push a button from the inside, you're good to go. So 6 gallon with a 16.2 gallon refresh rate per hour. This has a 100 gallon freshwater tank. So very big, you can go for a long time before you have to worry about having to refill. This is just a spot for your TV antenna, or I should say cable antenna. It does have an omnidirectional TV antenna built onto the top. The cool thing about that is it's a digital antenna. The kind that you see on top of coaches a lot of times is those big, huge arm ones that are metal. And the problem is they break, because mainly people forget to put it down because that's not what you're thinking about, because you're not looking up there all the time. The omnidirectional ones are nice because you can still turn them in different directions. And it's smaller and it doesn't take up as much room, much less chance of you ruining your rubber roof. And so that's a cool feature on this one that you don't have to maintain or worry about as much. This does have a 40 gallon fuel station built on board. So 40 gallons of fuel that feed the generator, as well as a fuel pump that feeds your toys. So you can fill up your four-wheeler or dirt bikes or whatever, as well as feed your generator off of one tank. This is nice because this is a collapsible ladder. So the way this works is you pull a couple pins and then this guy goes down. The nice thing about these types of ladders is if you are traveling down the road, this would actually be against DOT regulations, and so it's too wide at that point. So the fact that this folds up nicely is awesome, because that means you don't have to have a ladder inside your coach that you're having to deal with and have it be cumbersome. Let's take a look at a few cool features on the inside of the coach. So here we are inside the Stealth WA2715G series. A few other cool options and features in here. One is the electric bed lift. So over here on the cabinetry, you can push a button and this will start your generator right here, as well as control the bed going up and down. You can also pin this top bed up if you want. So if you're just going to use this as a couch, you can have that pinned up and not have to worry about headroom. It does come with a nice little ladder up here, so if you have to jump up there, you are able to do that just with the ladder. This does fold into a bed if you want it to. So folds down really easily. Let me show you what it looks like when you push it up. So you push this button. As you can see, it goes up kind of at a medium pace. It can handle a ton of weight on it. I think it's rated to like 600 pounds or something crazy. So more than enough for the average camper type of person. It does also, before I put it all the way up, I'll show you too. These do have curtains that pull across, so if you need a little bit of privacy, you have that to work with. So I'll have my camera guy push the rest of it up. Let's see here. Also, you'll notice this back area is a little bit taller than the front area. That's because you can get some of your taller toys in here and have the clearance that you need. Sometimes this stops right about here where it's not even quite 6 foot, which is a pain in the butt to get any of your taller toys in here. So yeah, these chairs right here are super comfortable. They're rocker swivel chairs. These would be awesome out on your front deck on the back area here, or your back deck, I should say. And then these tables here are removable. So you'll notice that there's no T-molding here or anything. It's just one piece of material so that you don't have to worry about it leaking on the side or cracking or something like that. And so the way this guy works is it just pops right off like that. Put this guy back here. And then these poles come out. And then this is just a piece of carpet that's laid on top of it to warm up the room. But you can see there's tie downs. There are 2,500 pound tie downs throughout. But this whole carpet comes up and you can see the tie downs go all the way along the back there. 1, 2, 3, 4, and then a couple along the middle and then more along this side too. Another thing that you'll notice too is this ramp is strong enough to drive your toys up into. So if you needed to get your toys really far up in here, you can. So you have a total of, from here to here is about 6 foot. Here to here is about 12 foot. And then from here to here is 15 foot. So that's why this is called the 2715. The way this couch works here is it has a couple clips right here on the side and a couple legs that come out. You can adjust these legs up and down, which is kind of nice because if it's a little wobbly, you can adjust this forward or backwards so it's not wobbly on you. And then this guy folds down flat. And then you're set. Windows throughout with the nice pleated shades. One, to hide your toys. Two, makes the room a little bit cooler. Three, the metal mini blinds tend to get dinged up, especially anytime you're by the bed. So like if somebody was sleeping right by this and their foot hit this and it's metal, it's gonna bend those little metal deals. So yeah, pleated shades are a little bit nicer for sure. These chairs are light enough too that you can take them out to your campsite, so you can go by, you know, your fire or just be out in the grounds or whatever, and you'll have the nicest camp chairs in the entire park for sure. Another thing to show you is this has the spice rack back here. This has the LG solid surface countertops, so these work as a cutting board slash sink covers. It has the large basin sink in here so that you can get your bigger, you know, a lot of times if you are a family, you're doing like a big pot or whatever, those don't fit in sometimes those RV sinks. This is big enough that you can do that. Has the high-rise sink faucet as well as the pull-down sink deal here. And they have the nice glass top that you can even use this as more counter space if you need to. And this folds up, makes a nice natural backsplash right here. And then has the oven and separate microwave instead of just the halftime oven. The cool thing about that is you're not having to run the oven with your generator on. You can just do it quietly and you're all set. It has the nice cup drawers here with the built-in silverware dividers already built into it. This is a little bit bigger fridge than most, so we optioned this one instead of with the 6 cubic foot refrigerator. We went ahead and optioned it with the 8 cubic foot refrigerator, which does give you quite a bit more space to work with. Frog, this is another little deal I'll tell you about. This is the Forest River Owners Group. So if you own a Forest River camper, you can join their group, and they have all kinds of cool stuff at no cost. You can go across the United States and join up with other fellow Forest River people and have fun and go to all kinds of different rallies and campsites and stuff like that. This one is just telling you a little bit about the GoPower solar panel. GoPower is one of the biggest names in the solar power industry. So zero fuel, it's super quiet, alternative compared to generators. And you get the freedom to go anywhere you want for as long as you want, because you're continually getting your batteries charged really fast at a 200 watt rate. Lots of cabinet space here. The other thing I like that Stealth does is they have a nice lip on the top here. So if you wanted to throw a bag of chips or bread or something like that up there, you can do that and it's not falling down. So yeah, good use of space there. This has the up part of the G series is the kicker audio system. So it has the built-in USB display as well as the micro SD card spot, AV auxiliary. It's touchscreen, so yeah, pretty darn cool stuff there. It has the fuel gauge as well as a charging center in here too, and a cork board. So you can plug in 12 volt as well as USB plugs. It'll monitor, tell you how full your battery is, your tanks and everything like that. So yeah, another cool setup. It's also where you turn on or you put out your power awning. Let's check out some cool stuff in the living room and or in the bedroom and the bathroom. One thing that I wanted to show you before we go in the bathroom is you have these two buttons, and I like that they light up to know if your heat pads are on. Those are on your tanks themselves so that they protect them from the cold weather, as well as a battery disconnect. I don't know if you'll be able to see this, but as soon as I disconnect this, all the lights go out in the entire coach. That way you're not accidentally draining your battery if you left a few lights on or something like that. This is the Jack and Jill style bathroom, so you can access it from the master bedroom, which does have its own door to it, which is kind of nice. You'll notice this has the nice neo-angled shower with tons of headroom to work with, so, and a skylight, so for some natural light. All LED lights throughout, and plenty of room as you saw. Medicine cabinet, as well as more storage underneath here too. So yeah, pretty cool unit. In here in the master bedroom area, this is a walk-around queen bed, so it's kind of nice that you have room to walk around it and make it instead of being shoved over into a corner. Also right here on this deal here, this is your controller deal to tell you how much you've used up your battery and how much solar power you're getting. It's the solar controller, so a 30 amp solar controller built in. Pass-through storage, or not pass-through, but storage underneath the bed there, as well as a little bit underneath here too. I don't know if you can see that or not. So, and then storage here. I also like how they have the little cutouts on both sides here. It does have the 12 or USB port and 12 volt port here. So if you wanted to charge your cell phone or something like that, as well as a 110 spot too. And then a little drawer on both sides as well. And then even more storage up above here. And it's high enough that even if you're laying in bed, it's not a head knocker. So you have plenty of room where it's not an issue. And then there is another 110 outlet on this side too. Ducted air conditioning in here, as well as a spot to put a second TV, or a first TV, I mean, because it has the cable outlet and 110 plug, and then this has got a backer built into it. So that's the Stealth WA2715G series. Come join us at thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, or come visit us here in Evans, Colorado. We're about an hour north of Denver on Highway 85. We'd love to help you out.